This footage shows Ukrainian band Kalush Orchestra on the market square at the western Ukraine's city of Lviv on April 2nd. This was the day when the band confirmed its possibility to participate in the Eurovision Song Contest 2022 in Italy's Turin. Earlier, there was no assurance in their possibility to participate due to a war in Ukraine. This is also the day when all band members have gathered live for a petition of the song which they presented at the Eurovision. And this footage shows the arrival of the Kalush Orchestra in Italy's Turin on the green carpet of the Eurovision. Kalush Orchestra presented song Stefania at the contest. And won. A leader of the band from the scene against the rules of the contest asked all viewers to support Ukraine in its efforts to save Mariupol defenders and those blocked in Azovstal.
Please help Ukraine, Mariupol! Help Azovstal right now!
Couple of days ago, the Kalush Orchestra band returned to Ukraine. The winners were being met right on the EU-Ukraine border by Ukrainian fans and the border guards.
We hope that the world will hear us and help us. We are proud of you.
Героям слава!
After the victory on Eurovision 2022, the pink Panama of Kalush Orchestra frontman has become a symbol. Thus, the Ukrainian postal service Ukrposhta announced the release of the stamp. At the same time, Ukrainian railway company Ukrzaliznitsa named one of the trains Stefania Express. This is the train number 4344 from Kyiv to Ivano-Frankivsk. This route was chosen by the company because it passes Kalush, the native town of the leader of Kalush Orchestra, Oleg Psyuk. His mother, Stefania Psyuk, lives in this town as well. At first, she had no idea that the song was dedicated to her.
He posted this song on the internet before the Eurovision, so I have heard it sooner. He also wanted to make a surprise, so I would hear this song for the first time at Eurovision.
And the residents of the town of Kalush, located in the Ivano-Frankivsk region in the western Ukraine, are proud of victory of their fellows.
We are waiting for them together with the victory, because here at this place there was a premiere of this song. I had no doubt that they would win. I was lying and watching with expectation that they will win. I was in seventh heaven. I worried about our guys. I also want to end the war as fast as possible, and it would be another big victory.
Already after the returning from Italy to Ukraine, leader of the Kalush Orchestra Oleg Psyuk on the very first press conference announced that they will sell the trophy of their victory, the glass microphone figure, in favor of Ukraine and its army needs.
There are many people who, in principle, can afford a large sum of money to help Ukraine. This statuette will be such a prize, an additional motivation to donate money to benefit the country and the army, and maybe someone wants to do that.
Musicians of the Kalush Orchestra band are indifferent to the ongoing war against Ukraine. Video for the clip of their winning song was filmed in Ukrainian cities and towns affected by the Russian war, in Bucha, Irpin and Hostomel. And after the visit of American actress and the UNHCR ambassador Angelina Jolie to the Lviv region, the artist thanked her for keeping world's eyes on Ukraine and published on the social media a plea to her. Quote, "Ask your talented friends from Hollywood to follow your steps and visit Ukrainians too."
Angelina, be the angel of peace to Ukraine, please.
And this is exactly that place where the artists confirmed their possibility to participate in the Eurovision 2022 months ago, Market Square in Ukrainian western Lviv. The artists walked throughout the square and spoke to fans. On the market square, artists also launched a social initiative. They opened a symbolic wall dedicated to the mothers of Ukraine, where everyone can write the name of his mother. The leader of the college orchestra was the first to write Stefania on it.
We gathered to write the names of our mothers. If you saw our clip for the song Stefania on YouTube, which we released the day before yesterday, there we show how we see Ukrainian mothers. That is why we want to send our gratitude to all Ukrainian mothers.
Afterwards, one of the Ukrainian travel bloggers, Maxim Uzul, caught them in a cafe nearby and asked them to address the viewers.
Thank you very much to all who support us. We urge everyone to help Ukraine in all aspects. Help informationally, talk about our situation in Ukraine, listen to our music, help culturally, and we will be grateful for your support and will always thank you.
Reported by Roman Smoller, UATV News.